What's up, footy fans? Your host, Hugh Roberts, getting ready to give you a day in life on an away day. Heading back to California, where I was the last 2 years doing a charity event, checking out Monterey Bay FC's game. We play Fuego as well, too. So travel with me this weekend, follow along, see what it's like in our life.
Getting ready to head back to the West Coast, so you know how to pack a little fit. Got my new J's on, so you know how to throw it in the bag real quick. Driving through the uptown Charlotte. We don't call it downtown, we call it uptown out here. Got to the airport, grabbed a little ticket. Got the security waiting at the gate, my boy KB. While we're waiting, play a little 22, play a little cards. Get to your seat, chilling with El Capitano. Play them with my homie from a long time. You know your boy's always working on the trips. Get to the Fresno airport, which was pretty dope. See all the trees and, you know, the designs up behind that. From the airport, go straight on the bus, go straight to the training field. Throw your clothes on right there on the bleachers kind of thing, on the benches. Put your boots on, whatever, straight from the flight. Do a little quick little warm-up. We knew it was a lot of days just because it came from the flight, but we wanted to get the flight out of our legs real quick. Do a three-man passing, nice and easy. Get your legs out of it, too. From there, Mike let us have a little fun playing a little tag as well. As you see, the boys is having some fun. You know, just the vibes is good. Make sure we're having good energy before going to this game. From there, play a little rondo, put the boys in the frenzy, making them have a little spin cycle, just keeping them in the middle as long as you can. You know, just more good vibes, laughter, you love to see it. And at the end, it's the Young Bucks' birthday, Denzel, so had a little surprise for him at the end. So the rooms look like at the hotel. Now we're on the bus next day, getting ready for the game day. Pulling up to Fresno University on their campus. This is what the inside of the locker room looks like. Right from there, you kind of walk to the field, see what stud you're going to wear, see what the vibes is like, what the atmosphere is going to be. You know, it's just a good time as well to assess the field before you step on it. Boys put in the shift tonight, got their first away victory. Good vibes, good energy. Mike Jeffries, you know, just sending off, reaffirming all that as well too. Get back to the hotel, superstar himself, has to sign a little autograph. But yeah, for me the next day, I'm heading to Monterey from Fresno, got a 2.5 hour drive, got my rental car, getting ready to follow me as we get ready for my foundation. This is NorCal, a little gloomy, a little rainy, but you love to see all the agriculture out here as well. This is me and Walmart buying a bunch of sweaters, sweatpants, long sleeves. A little chilly out here, so I want to make sure people have their essentials. Pretty much buying the whole rack of items from places and from things. You know, and again, it's just wanted to give you behind-the-scenes access to me buying some more sweats. It's for males and females, children and adults. Making sure we can fit all sizes as well, too. But a little bit of insight to what I've been doing, what I did straight from the hotel the next day after my game. So then from there, check out real quick. These are the items so you can see. Put the bags in the car. Heading out to Monterey to Seaside Boys and Girls Club, where we pulled up and met the Monterey Food Bank with their truck, where they give a bunch of agriculture, bunch of vegetables, onions, you know, asparagus, whatever you need, lettuce, everything. So just some pictures for you to see. Family's excited, grabbing soccer balls, grabbing clothes. I'm so thankful to be able to do this. From there, getting ready to go see the Monterey soccer games. But before then, I had to stop by my old crib, check up on it. It's where I lived last year. From there, I went to a black-owned business called Deja Blue. That's a jazz place. Grabbed a drink real quick. Then I pulled up to the Monterey boys game, Monterey Bay FC game. This is weird for me. I was here the last 2 years. To be a spectator is definitely a little different. But, man, it's just great to see the growth of the club, how the boys have progressed, how, you know, the atmosphere, how packed it is every game. Star Wars night as well, too. So they're giving out some free lightsabers for the kids, which is great. But it's good to see everyone else involved. There's the VIP section over there as well, too. But thank you guys, you know, for making me feel at home, definitely. Man, it was I wouldn't say a dream come true, but definitely once in a lifetime kind of night. Just reminiscing. This is more views from the VIP, so I got to see some old fans, old VIP members, people that I've been, you know, had good memories of the last 2 years. Had some old fans reach out to me to come to the fan section. So this is me walking on the side of the bleachers, seeing some old fans, fans wearing my jersey. Shout out to you, man. I really appreciate you still rocking me years later. seen the homie Chase Boone do his thing, all the other boys do their thing out there, and just to see good familiar faces still working hard doing their thing, making me proud and honored as well too. So all the goals, you know, and you know, you miss these sunset, you miss these views out here as well. So you come out to Cali for it. Just wanted to give you guys some more access behind the scenes to what I saw that night before the game. And then from there, you know, I had the chance to see, now, you know, chilling with the fans and them. So I'm in the supporter section for the first time. Shout out to you guys for the anthem, for the chant, just making me feel at home and making me feel that first experience out there. But from there, I had a red eye that night. We have a game against Atlanta United that Tuesday, so I had to go straight from there, straight to the airport in San Fran, hopped on the flight, back on the East Coast. I appreciate you for tuning in. Stay tuned for more.